Now, today we're going to do a product demo and tour of the American Audio VMS2. What comes in the box? VMS2 itself. Also, some goodies here like the product manual, American DJ Advantage flyer. Turn the lamp here. AccuCable flyer, American Disc Jockey Association, important notice, and manufacturer warranty card, along with goodies such as two American DJ bumper stickers. Also, down there, the rack installation unit, so you can just hook them on and you can install your VMS2 into a rack. It also came with a larger magazine-type flyer with American DJ products. And, of course, the unit itself right here, along with the AC 6-volt, I think, power adapter, which is kind of hard to find. I looked all over my house, couldn't find anything on any other product I have, plus the square USB cable. Let's take a product tour. Now, what we have in the middle is an analog mixer. It mixes even the two channels of audio that it gets from the laptop, which is pretty neat. Other MIDI controllers don't do that, which is what makes the VMS2 unique. Now, let's start over here. Pitch slider, sync button, six different loop points, loop buttons. I mean, there's three of them there, and then there's a shift button, so you can access six. Loop in, loop out, re-loop and loop, smart loop, key lock, and vinyl or CD scratch, and then search buttons, okay, and they all light up. On the whole unit, there's 32 light-up buttons, not including the level meter. The reason it has a level meter is because it is an analog mixer, and you don't overload it like this. Okay, play, pause, cue, touch-sensitive platters, pitch bend, cue, load on each deck, and this neat little click wheel button, which we'll get to in just a sec. In the mixer itself, we'll have a crossfader, which is replaceable. Four screws here, you can just pop it out, put in a better one if you wish. Gain, treble, mid, bass, booth volume for your booth speaker, because there's a separate output for that in the back, we'll get to that in a second. And master volume. So you want to keep the level output at around peaking at zero, which is yellow. There's only one yellow LED. Now, this is the skin it comes with, of course. I forgot to mention. It comes with Virtual DJ LE with the Izio sound driver, which is required to use this thing as a sound card. And the VMS2 skin, which is what we're using right now. I don't like it. I don't use it. But it looks pretty similar to what we have here. Now, my song has ended, so I guess I might as well show you how to use the click wheel. After, I'm just going to put a song on here. Now, down here, we have some more controls. Mic on and off. It has a separate mic input, so you can, once you have your gain and your tone setting set, which is right here, you can just put mics on, no volume control needed, and you can talk to your crowd. Now, each channel on the mixer has, you can have an analog input if you have like a CD player or a turntable or an iPod or something that you want to mix, and you don't have another mixer, use the VMS2. You can switch between MIDI and analog input, which I don't have anything plugged into right now. Reverse crossfader switch, crossfader curve switch, which basically controls the steepness of the crossfader, I guess, if that's a word. Headphones, you can fade between Q and master output, and headphone gain, of course, with a quarter-inch jack. On the back, power switch on and off. That doesn't, when it's plugged in USB, I don't think that power switch does much, except it does give a little bit of preamplification. DC 6-volt, I mean, adapter input, USB. Hopefully you can see better. Balanced output, XLR, left and right. That's pretty neat. Booth output and RCA, master output and RCA, which you can't see because I'm using it and it's plugged in. Next we have inputs for, RCA inputs for deck 2 and for deck 1. You can switch between phono and line, so like here's a ground here you could use for a record player on each deck. And of course the nifty little XLR, I know you can't see it, I'm sorry, XLR and quarter inch input jack in one. That's pretty neat. And that's basically your overall tour of the VMS2. Look at this click wheel here. Turn it, and I'll be scrolling through your playlist. Now, that's a CD on right now, the U2 album that they released after 360 tour of some live shows. So you can scroll up and down, and just say you want to just do Beautiful Day. So you go and scroll till it's highlighted, then press load on the side you want it to load, and there it loads, okay? That's pretty simple. Now, with this knob, you can also do effects. So what you do for that is you press up, if you want to use the left deck, is the up button, ironically. And then when you turn the knob, you're scrolling through different effects. Let's look for Flanger. There we go, right there. Press the middle button. You can kind of hear it in the camera, I hope. And it flashes when it's on. And then you can use the wheel while the effect is on to control one of the parameters. And then, boop, click it again and it turns off, and then you're scrolling through again. And if you want to access the right deck, you press the down button, and then now you're scrolling through right deck effects. Now, to go through this part of the browser, you press the left button, and then you're scrolling through that part of the browser. Go through the main part of the browser, you either click on the folder you want to go to, or you press the right button. That is how that click wheel works in a nutshell. Now, the cue function is sort of different, okay? Just say, well, Out of Control here is playing on this deck. I want to listen to how this song sounds. What you have to do, first of all, is take your master cue fader, put it all the way to cue. Now, what you have to do, though, is since there's a cue button on each side, you have to make sure, boop, that's on. So then the leveler is now leveling what the cue light is on, okay? So that's PFL'd. Hit play, and now it's outputting to my headphones, which are right there and you can't hear. Want to hear both of them at the same time without the crossfader effect? Just do that. I know I can't really explain that clearly without you actually playing around with it, but it's pretty simple. And that is the VMS2 quick product tour. Well, let's take a... I'm going to switch over to a more electronic song for you. And that way you can hear... Oh, yes. I'm going to explain the mixer. Since this mixer is analog and not digital, and it doesn't do the computer's mix, and the computer actually takes... It outputs the sound as two different channels on each deck to two different inputs, well, digitally through USB, on this board. So then, even though the MIDI is still controlling like a normal MIDI controller, the mixer is actually analogically mixing the two decks. Same thing with the treble. In fact, when you go into config and hit mappers, for example, if I pick treble, it says it's mapped as fake EQ high. So it shows up in the skin, but it doesn't do anything. So that way you get some awesome American Audio treble control down here. Same thing with the crossfader and the volumes, and the bass, master volume, and the gain, I think. Maybe not the gain, when you're in MIDI mode. Anyways, let's look at an electronic song so we can play around with some looping and stuff. I'm going to pick Good Time by Owl City and Carly Rae Jepsen. Turn it up so you can hear me over here. Oh,
bass. It sounds fantastic, by the way, the sound quality of this thing. Now let's loop this next verse in. Now there's one thing about this unit that I don't understand. And that's when it loops, it doesn't automatically make... It doesn't automatically make the loop and loop it directly on the guiding dot, as it should. So sometimes you have to be right on the dot on the beat in order for it to loop properly. Otherwise, if you're in sync with another, with the other deck, then it'll be off beat. One of the beats will be slightly shorter or longer than the other side, and it'll mess up, and you'll have to press sync every time, or pitch bend every time that the loop comes along. So let's take a look at some Felguk. Side by side. Listen to that. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm just going to switch skins here, you guys, because I don't like this one, and I don't use it. I just put it on for this video. The one I normally use is MixLab 3.1, which is pretty common. There. Now, so you can see, I have my loop going there. I'll just pause that. Now, sync this deck. I don't normally use the sync button, but I am just for time's sake. And... now this song wasn't really scanned properly, so I'll just use my pitch bend buttons to put it in place. There. Now they're synced. But with each loop, see how they grow farther apart? I'll just use pitch bend. With each loop, they're growing farther apart. And that's no good. I don't know how that works. So I can, anyways, loop out. 1, 2, 3. Anyways, I'll loop out, and then look, check this out. So I can use cue point 1 as that. That's pretty neat, eh? Now we'll find a different space. Anyways, I can have up to 6 cue points. There's 3 buttons, but I can use shift. Because there's a shift button. When shift is held in, then it's doing whatever that bolded or that yellow, that white stuff underneath each button is for. Okay? Pitch slider works pretty good. Now I can unlock the key by shift and that. So let's throw some effects on you. So in order to do that, I gotta press down to bring me to the right deck. And then I'll scroll through the effects. Let's take the phaser. Thank you. beautifully cute. And it's full kill on the EQ too. Full kill. EQ reverse. Mike. That's about all I can tell you about the American Audio VMS2. Rate, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching. Any suggestions on some different videos, let me know. Shoot them down in the comment section. Hopefully I'll get some gig logs up in the near future. VMS2 by American Audio. Peace.